Good morning or good night to everyone, depending on your time zone. In my case, good night. And as the chairman said, I am Javier García Alba, and I work as a technologist in IH Cantabria, Environmental Hydraulic Institute of the University of Cantabria, where I am part of the Oceanography, Estuaries and Water Quality Department. Next, I'm going to make a presentation about SOSIS, a predictive application to obtain electronic flags based on machine learning. First of all, we're going to talk about the inception of this SOSIS tool. Let's go to quantify the problem. Approximately, there are 360,000 annual deaths from drowning all around the world, according to the World Health Organization. For instance, there is one drowning every 91 minutes in Brazilian beaches, being the largest risk of death for teenagers, according to Brazilian Lifeguards Association. Classical projects exist to obtain electronic flags, but all of them were based on process models with high computational resources. So they are not valid to give a quick response, and they are not easy scalable to new areas. On the other hand, Sustainable Development Agenda from United Nations said, ensuring healthy lives and promoting the well-being at all ages. So in order to avoid this issue, we developed SOSIS for the analysis of the dynamic risk on beaches using Copernicus Marine Service data and artificial neural networks, ANN. Then we obtained funds from a call of Copernicus Marine Environment Service to develop SOSIS tool. And in this slide, you can see the main aim of this project. Anybody can wonder, what will be the beach conditions in order to go and safely enjoy it? Well, using historical data, we trained an ANN system by using Copernicus forecasting product to provide electronic flags. Green, no danger. Yellow, be careful. And red, danger. We adopted these classifications because it's the most accepted type of electronic flag used in Europe and America. This information will be useful for beach users and lifeguards in order to visit or watch the beaches. The pilot slash study site was Santa Catarina County in Brazil with 139 coastal beaches. We found different kinds of beaches in that area, an important factor to generate a more robust tool. Brazilian Life Saving Society, SOBRASA, provided us two databases, a drowning database with more than 50,000 records and a flag database with around 80,000 records. Moreover, we got from reanalysis products, winds, currents, water level, and waves, and the correlation, and we obtained the correlation between meteorological condition and these databases. So with all of this information, we performed a beach characterization in order to get the model state of all Santa Catarina beaches and carried out a cross-cutting analysis to obtain the correlation between beach type, forcings, and flags. After this analysis, we found the best inputs for the ANN system were significant wave height, mean period, incidence angle of waves, beach model state, wind module, and marine currents module in order to provide an electronic flag, green, yellow, or red. We performed too and applied a contingency table and error matrix to assess the quality of the ANN, obtaining a great value of the success index of 0.81 and a hit rate of 0.87, both values over one. Once the core engine of the system was developed, we connected the system to the Copernicus Nowcast and Forecast services to feed the ANN. In this slide, you can see that we use the global forecasting products of Copernicus. In these two tables, you can see the different products that we used. In this other slide, we show the SOSIS architecture. Orange elements like electronic flag or monitoring gene correspond to calculation processes. Blue elements like these ones to databases that save the calculations and the pre-processed metocean data. And finally, the purple elements show the visualizations, like the SOSIS app or web monitor. The app works both in iOS and Android devices as a dynamic progressive app and in computer with the web application. Finally, and as an example, I show the visualization provided by SOSIS app for an electronic flag forecasting on a beach. In this case, as you can see in the left part of this slide, a green flag. Furthermore, metocean forecasting information is out in the right part. Both information can obtain it using the application. And in the bottom part of the slide, I show the web and the website. Finally, the conclusion of that project. A cross-reference analysis between historical flag events and metocean conditions was performed with the Copernicus products, finding a non-linear relationship. This was the starting point for the use of artificial neural networks in that case. An ANN system has been developed based on deep learning to predict electronic flag using the Copernicus products. A third conclusion, an operational system, SOSIS, has been released integrating the developed ANN and the metocean conditions, real-time and forecasting Copernicus products, to provide tailored information about the dynamic risk on beaches based on electronic flag criteria. And the last one, SOSIS tool is available at Santa Catarina beaches, Brazil, and fully scalable to any worldwide beach. And it should be noted that the SOSIS tool is now being tested in 4 beaches or Lake Macquarie in Australia, thanks to Smart Beaches. Thanks, Tony, and all of your collaborators, including Lake Macquarie Council. And in that moment, we did some analysis of forcing and programming some parts to connect to the metocean providers, but it's not finished and it's under development. So thanks all, and thank you so much for your attention.